losing the game. And that's kind of the theme right now of Kane is, sure, he has a really good early game, has some good damage in that part where he can duel the junglers level like 3 onwards.
Did he take W?
He's gonna have Q and E.
Straight to the wall. Zig's like, oh, where did this guy come from? Contract's
gonna
take out on this. Will be first blood. Contract's gonna grab it.
Yeah, it looked like Impact didn't show that he had taken an ability there, the Q or the W. And
they
just,
see it?
Yeah. They saw it.
Just barely. There's the Ace in the Hole into Expecial. He's gonna be the dive target through the portal. We go. Contract planning the slow. Immunes himself using the Umbral Trespass in onto Expecial. Damage coming through. Expecial's got nowhere good to run. And Contract is gonna grab kill number 2.
Yep. Doesn't blow anything there like the exhaust. In mid lane though, Mike Young.
Oh, Jensen with so much pressure. Jensen gonna try and get that solo kill, but Mike Young looking for the assassination. Everybody moving out. There's the root. Mike Young nabs Jensen.
And there's the wall as well, just to cut off Jensen, and just in case. But that's gonna be that bottom turret going down because of the 3-man.
Can move their pressure to this mid lane.
Yeah, but they don't have control of the side. Here comes Cho'Gath in. If they overextend, there's a possibility.
Trap underneath as well. Shockwave there. Sneaky gets an easy kill and arrow. Forced to flash away. Gonna get Ace in the hole and taken down. Maybe the ignite is enough for Smoothie able to get it. Cho'Gath though, roaming down, takes down Sneaky. It's actually Mike Young that gets kill credit there. Popping them out, looking to siege down the turret. Bottom side looks like Chop for Imbrax. The 3-man Root's gonna maybe save the day and the turret. Immunes again. Now 4v1 for Imbrax. He's trying to get away. Mike Young, we're gonna do what he can, but an amazing knockback from Imbrax. He's gonna keep the play going. He finally dies to Mike Young, but C9 already ahead on him.
He gets the ulti down. Nabs one. It's Expecial as Marco ulti.
He's gonna time it in with a Bard Stasis. Not quite enough. Expecial finally gets caught on the end. The Ace in the hole there. The Shockwave gets him a kill. The Rift Herald still going, charging into the turret. Into the tier 2 P1, looking to fight a 4v5.
Just trying to get mid priority over the wall though.
Impact, flash W in, that's gonna knock somebody back. Rift forever, period, goodbye. The ulti's gonna strangle up everybody else. Expecial tries to disengage, the Shockwave is gonna miss as P1 flash out of the way, but Cloudland again find the pick.
This Maokai is just ridiculous, just creating a gigantic wall of zoning, but also creating pressure.
Contract got the red buff, now gonna trespass into Mike Young. Mike Young get assassinated here. Looks about the Contract. Massive play, no win to arrows. Cloud now pick it up again, and Contract, he dove to the wall looking for blood.
And get back, but now that he's ahead, it just looks kind of hard to shut it down. You're going to need an Executioner's Calling to deal with it.
And that's a swift Baron for Cloud9%,
and then it's like 40 plus.
They found 2 Contracts again, lining it up. There's a great knock up onto Arrow, followed in by Smoothie in the stun. And Arrow just gonna get taken down. Sneaky able to find the assassination. Another great flanking. Maokai L finds Mike Young dead to Impact. Cloud9 setting up every play so well, and this is the pace P1.
Think back to when he first brought it out. It's like, why isn't this being played everywhere? And now you can see the Rost, Kane, like Cloud9 definitely did their homework. And yeah, it doesn't matter, Sneaky can still hit that.
Yeah, he's gonna shoot it over the wall. Angle not quite there for Tyrion to cut it off, and already taking another mid in here. Remember, they got Baron 2 minutes ago, so.
Yep.
Huge empowered pushes here for C9, as they're looking to take down this top inhibitor. That will be 2, and C9 already 12,000 ahead of Phoenix One.
And they just blew up, period.
Oh, goodbye.
I know, he got annihilated there. Jensen still has ult.
Oh, nine, and they impact again. Flash root in onto Mike Young, gonna try and take him down. Contract zips back forward as Mike Young flashes to safety, but third and hip down, and this Nexus looking very vulnerable.
Yep. 25 minutes, 40 seconds. They're trying to go for
all
the
right,
jungler.
Turret going down. Contract's gonna dip in. Arrow gonna carry him into the found of it. Contract gets blown back as his GA will be popped. Smoothie with a good ult. The Shockwave to follow.
Just 3
destroys P1. There's a triple kill. The Jensen might be chasing into the found for a few more. The 4 kill is gonna come. Jensen has a Quadra.
Oh, dive. Impact is gonna do it.
Impact in there. The rest of the score goes in. Oh no, that was missed time, Jensen. Might just wait for it. I think he's hoping Expecial gifts it over, but the Nexus might die before they can complete it. It's gonna go down. Sneaky shuts it down by shooting the Nexus, but a win's a win. Penta beat
it. Refreshes the cooldown, and it looks ridiculous. And the kind of the icing on the cake there is every time you do that, the Bravado passive also reduces the cooldown of
his feet. Here comes Jensen. Feel this invade. Jensen's gonna roam up as well. Contest aiming up that kick. Landed the Q already.
Oh.
Have to be careful though. Gonna push the wave all the way in, and now Zeke can't really run anywhere. Does knock up Impact, but damage still coming out. The silence is good. Jensen taking up a few too many hits, but first blood over to Contracts.
Yeah, they're gonna dive perfectly on top of Zeke. Shutting him down. Contracts level advantage here, and they're gonna be able to pressure this down.
Ultimate from Sneaky.
Jensen's got ulti.
Gonna poke in. There's a Taric ult. Gonna try and wait it out. Can still be CC though. Contracts flash kicks one back in, but the TP down from Sin. I'm gonna try and complete the play. Contract too far as marking him. Take him down, and Pyrion has entered this bot lane. Jensen now gonna have to
pushing
run.
And clearing waves. The answer here is actually very poor.
Tower dive. Zig actually the target, but he flashes out of the way. Contracts again needs to get back to the lantern. And
here
does
Talia.
In fact, rode in. Jensen gonna try and cut them off, but the wall's a little short there at rank 1.
Yeah, and they have to clear out the mini wave if they want to do anything
here. Good taunt actually on the Pyrian. Does get rid of it. Good play there from Smoothie. And kills across the water special. Ultimate finally finishes channeling, but that's far too late.
These have been awful answers.
No follow-up there from Phoenix One. As C9 continue to see here in mid.
Yeah, and Phoenix One just kind of have to stop the bleeding and
Attention to the target. He's going to try and get peeled away. Good stun there as Pyrian able to land that kill. Mike Young does fall down. The ultimate Phoenix special to try and continue the play, but
try to kill Zig here.
Not quite getting cut off here, but the rest of the team's there. Puts the wall down, hops off, and now Zig gonna get rooted back in. Knocked the other way, as there's the play from Smoothie. Just knocked around all over the place. Zig falls to Jensen.
Yep, and now mid lane arrow shuffles, right?
Yeah.
It's like, what are you going for? Oh,
daggers, only daggers.
Flank.
Good cut off there from Jensen, but the ulti from Xpecial might turn it back around. Paul gonna try and
he
land
in,
but a great double stun. The root lands in, but the play back from Smoothie is Jensen barely alive, gets healed
he
out of it.
This.
But the massive amount of knockoffs gonna lock up contact impact. Still trying to fight it out, but C9 on the retreat. Another good knockback experience chasing him down. Impact, he's tying up as many as he can, but the carries are going to finally get a pick on Depirion. Impact going down, fighting. He gets feasted on by Zig. Huge teamfight win for P1.
P1 want this, and right now, Mike Young is kind of getting blown up.
They don't want this, though.
Zig has to take it. Both the Dragon and the shots. Ah, Mike Young is going to actually get one back there. Jensen's going to try to flank. He's going to try to kill.
Oh, Mike Young.
Oh, he went to the Dragon.
A few more seconds. Zig now gets chased down. Stinky, Silence gonna land in. Stinky gonna get knocked up, but he dodges the next hit. Movement speed, no, not enough. The autos do take him down. And P1 even gonna get the Drake out of the deal.
All right.
Very vulnerable.
Yep, turret dive. Smoothie's gonna try to save him.
And Zig's gonna try and deny that impact up as
Are
well.
He's
gonna try
die?
And buy a lot more time. Silence lands in, but Smoothie able to kite them out for a little while. Longer route lands in. There's the Tornado's arrow actually takes that contact on the other side of the map. Press the P1 up here though.
Whoa. All that damage on the arrow. Now, as soon as it hits, they're gonna dive.
Time to dive in. Flash stun for Xpecial. Finds two. Impact back in with the root, but Cloud9 still fighting it out.
Oh.
Jensen with a good little bit of root down, but does take down Zig as the ult wears off.
Wants arrow, he wants arrow.
Jensen looking for arrow, does get it, but Jensen now snared up. Finds a triple, but is gonna fall down. Mike Young able to get that kill on another Bloodbath in top lane.
This is once every six games. We'll see.
Oh my goodness.
Power of Taric makes it in this
Mike
game.
Mike Young flashes in. The wall's going to move them all back in. A huge Bouncer Castle gets one. A sneaky fall. Smoothie going to go down next to the impact. He makes it in time with the ultimate, but I don't think he can save anybody else.
Yeah, Xpecial's the one zoning, but there's easier access to arrow.
Yeah, Impact actually moving in as Xpecial does move in. Decent wall there from Jensen trying to trap them in the pit. But Impact is straight into the back of it. This Baron should be P1.
Nom it.
But they actually just keep fighting. Does nom it down and goes over to Phoenix 1 and now stunned into the pit. That's Impact falling down to the rest of P1.
Whoa.
Aggressed on Pyrian.
Deathfire.
Get a kill. DFT's enough. There's a double kill for Kassadin.
And they messed up and Phoenix 1 even split pushing. They don't have as many TPs. And the Kassadin is just really difficult to answer. Here comes the dive.
Another Maokai ulti.
Looking for turret damage more than anything.
Everybody's owned out of the way. Gets a double root on the back end of it. As Zina, I'm going to try and find it out.
Derek ulti.
Baikang actually. Oh, actually, kicked out of it. Doesn't get in. Is Jensen able to pick him off? But Impact already fell. Inhibitor turret falls down. And now the inhib itself threatened by the rest of P1. A hook lands again. They're in onto Zig. Forced to flash out of the way. C9 still do a decent amount of damage as Project faints in, baiting out that turret.
Hit all your buttons. Let's force it. Toledo wall comes out.
Oh, nice wall actually going to cut off Pyrian, but he's the one that gets over it easily. So Rift Walk over, Sivirolt on. Zig taking damage on the front line, but he soaks so much. Hasn't even popped the stone plate yet. Inhibitor does fall down. P1 just brute force their way through there in top lane.
Just wards.
I mean, they get a little bit of temporary vision.
They're actually going to continue to give them vision here. Zig is kind of in charge of the smite duties here.
Yep.
They have Taric ulti.
Gonna try and kill Xpecial, but he's just a little too tanky. Good knockback again. The invulnerability is coming down as Mike Young already taken down. Impact Smoothie bound up by the Nature's Grasp. And Pyrian dominating takes him down as Jensen's followed in from the root. Pyrian's gonna flash forward and knock them all back.
Game.
And Pyrian gonna grab that double sneaky. One of the few remaining members. Now Data's arrow gets that kill on Contracts, who cut the wave as best he can, but P1 gonna try and end through
top. They don't
top
want
lane.
That wave. They're gonna go through top exactly like you said, Pastry. Phoenix 1 trying to strike back here. This is most likely end the game here with 30-second death timers.
Respawns a little too long. TP in from P1. Trogath will return to the scene of the crime. Nexus turret one down. Nexus too soon to follow, and Zig, a celebratory righteous glory, romping through the Nexus. Phoenix 1 gonna tie it all up and force a third game. This series has been so much fun.
That's fine. I'll take Alistar.
Yep. Speedy Cow in the bottom lane. Got the buff to his ultimate that is now 5% higher damage reduction at all ranks. So 55 going all the way up.
P1 have done a really good job kind of responding to a very, very new threat. And
Maikung even trying to camp out. He's going to get stunned as a result. Looking for the all-in, but the flash body slam into the cart. Jones is going to try and get the kill, but the knockoff from Special claims Maikung first blood.
Yeah, you'd have to answer with teleport right now. Before Impact can interrupt it. Now they're flanked in. This is actually really bad for Phoenix One.
Context is actually moving in, trying to seal it perhaps, but there's actually a kill onto Maikung. Goes down as Sneaky. Able to get the kill. Now Sneaky still firing away into Expecial as the passive. Who's going to proc from Bomb? Concussive Blow seals Expecial's fate. And C9 win the fight and get the drink.
Pin him down. And look at this, just the rotation to the other side.
C9 here first though, good Miasma. Zig gonna get slowed up there, the stun lands through Zig. Gonna get trespass on him, Jensen able to get the kill. Contracts now trying to get up, but Impact's there to save him. Contracts flashes back towards his team. Mitara getting low, P1 can't defend. 5v2 as Expecial gets snared up. Has his ulti, but it's just gonna get stunned to death.
Keep going.
Able to get the kill.
And they are just being outplayed in terms of the rotation
almost
game.
The Seraph's ready to go, and two items done for Sneaky means that Cloud9, they're ready. The team fight is marking him back in onto Jensen, who does flash out of the way. Expecial taking damage in the front side. Humble Trespass gonna burn that ulti. Smoothing Flash
off to
the knockup. Maokai ulti also gonna chase him in. It's the Glacial Bitter slowing them all down. There's one rune, there's a knockup. There's another double rune. Sneaky gets that kill. Two for himself already, as that's another one. Kane able to grab it. That's four dead on the side of Phoenix One. Arrow gonna run back to the turret because he's the only one left.
Yep, he's got some weight.
What's going on?
Uh-oh, Jensen.
Alright,
stand and fight. Oh, maybe not for too much longer. A chain of stuns will land. Good spell shield from Arrow. Pyrion's gonna join the party as well, and credit over to the Corki.
Baron up in 10 seconds. That's actually big, because now there's a Pontrax, also a large part of their gold lead, up two levels.
Just very sticky. Bit of damage here on the ulti. Gonna walk back through that wall and just kind of bait them all in. Another good double knockup as the blast guns back over the other side of terrain. Contrax, knowing all the ins and outs, Expecial's gonna be the one left out to dry. Just a lot of stuns. Gonna follow that. And such a sticky champion as well.
And I like that he's messing around with the mobility. He's playing around with it.
Ooh, all right, they're gonna watch Maikung. They're gonna burst him down. Should be able to get him. Arrow though kills Smoothie. Maikung does fall, but Contract's on a rampage to get back on the other side of the wall.
Yeah, Maikung has saved games before at Baron. Zig though. Zig flashes.
Zig is still killing. He wants to try and beast it away. Zig just goes in and takes the Baron down. Cloud9 will get the kill. Contract's chasing. Gonna try and take down another, but Pyrion backs out of the way and Contracts can't find him.
So the Cho'Gath flashes in, finishes off the Baron with the E, the percent HP damage, but who's gonna live with it?
Oh no. Expecial frozen in midair with the headbutt as he goes down to Jensen. Arrow's still gonna get chased. Contracts. Yes. Pyrion helps out. We're gonna fight on the bottom side. Maokai ulti already expanded his Contracts, dives in, but he's actually have to use the ulti to try and defend himself there. Dashes out of the way, but not quite enough.
Oh,
the
stun
knockoff, but Contracts is gonna fall. Jensen flashes in though to try and finish off.
Trying to get Jensen.
Knocks him back into the team. Sneaky still needs to keep moving, but he gets hit by the back by Expecial. Arrow grabs the
door. Oh my
God! A miraculous team fight on the bot side. Almost acing Cloud9. In fact, that is the ace.
I don't even know what just happened there. So, same with Sneaky. So this is actually something where Alistar is in a great position to dive with a Sivir ultimate.
Sneaky might be a little too keen on this fight, but Maikung stunned up by Concussive Blows. Everyone gonna dive big. Give it the Maokai ult. Wonderful there from Impact. They just have to try and kill Arrow. Impact soaking what he can. A Sneaky still free-firing, but a good cast separates the carry there from C9. Might still be too far ahead of Sneaky. Gonna get assassinated by Contract's ulti. Up. And there's Alistar going down. Pyrion gonna get exhausted. Cloud9 gonna force them off these inhibs and retake mid once more.
Yeah, great from C9 for Sneaky and Jensen not to stand next to each other at all. They've made that mistake against a team like CounterLogic Gaming, and they don't stand next to each other. You see, Expecial really has to choose who his target is. Gets rooted, takes him a lot of time. Eventually goes on to Jensen side. Don't want to do that on the top. They're just gonna use the Baron. Slow shove in, try to get that third inhib.
Inhib is available as the turret goes down. But again, just patience required here for C9. They're going to have Baron up super minions soon if they want to walk towards mid or bot. It looks like the siege is going to be pretty well sustained here.
Yeah, but there's a big bottom lane wave, so they'll let that shove in. That bottom tier, tier 4 slash Nexus turret. The Nexus turret is really low on the bottom side, so these minions will be able to push in and get that. So they're just sticking around. They're much stronger as well, anyway.
Contracts the one kind of far forward, dashes on a Zig. Righteous Corey popped on
the go in.
Gonna give him some healing. Contracts gets a good health back all the way in as the inhib goes down. Maokai ultimate up to the side, gonna find him on the flank angle. Alistar again knocked up forever. That's Maikung, excuse me, as he falls down. Expecial pumps the ulti back in onto Jensen and Smoothie, Sneaky and Smoothie, but that's not enough as he grabs the double. But triple kill there for Sneaky. It might be finally here as Kane revives with the GA. Oh, Arrow again. Arrow moves forward. Sneaky still wicking. There's Arrow coming down. That's going to be the Quadra. No, he needs the dab. Doesn't use it. Sneaky firing away. There's the shutdown of the Quadra. And the unofficial Fester kill goes over to Sneaky. Cloud9 get the ace, grab the Nexus, and win the series.
A little bit too much time between.